we're ready. How many is excited about this day?
Amen.
I'm excited. I woke up at 8:30 this morning. I said, I'm excited. I'm ready.
Amen.
Man, I was pumped this morning. I didn't pump no arms or nothing, but I pumped this right here this morning.
Amen.
I pumped that right there, and that'll make you stronger than anything you can ever be.
Right.
Hallelujah. We're going to go before the Lord in prayer this morning. I'm going to ask Brother Wayne to open us up in prayer this morning. And let's just get in and have church. You want to help Nora this morning, Sister Connie and Sister Misty? Y'all come and help her this morning.
Your Heavenly Father,
bless the Lord God as we come to you, God. We thank you, God, for this morning.
Thank you for your love.
Thank you, Lord God, for your blessings, God, that you have blessed this church with, that you have blessed us with, God. God, we just ask, God, that you come in this place this morning. God, that we'll give you praise, we give you glory, we give you honor this morning, God, where honor is due this morning, God. God, we just ask you just have your way this morning, God. Not our will, but your will be done in this place. God, let the Holy Ghost come in this place this morning, and let it saturate our souls this morning, God, we ask. God, we give you all the praise and all the glory this morning, God. You're worthy to be lifted up, you're worthy to be praised this morning. God, as we thank you for it, God, we just ask you to have your way this morning. God, we give you praise and glory, God. We ask it all in your Son's name, Jesus. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let's give our live stream audience again a praise for them this morning. Give them a thank you for watching. Hallelujah. Thank you out there. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
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 I'm still praising on some
books. I don't get this drug.
Praise on some books.
This will help souls to the best of them.
I'm not afraid.
Oh,
say, God, I want the Holy Ghost just to sit upon. I want to feel the Holy Ghost just pushing down upon you this morning. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It's time we come in the house of God. Glory to God. We're expecting God to do something. Hallelujah. A lot of people don't get nothing because they don't expect nothing. Glory to God. We got to expect something to get something. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I better hush or I'll get into my message. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Jesus is worthy to be praised this morning. Hallelujah. They can praise everything else. They can praise a football player. They can praise a wrestler. They can praise a basketball star. Glory to God. They can praise every man they want to. But I come into the house of God to praise the Lord. Go to the Lord in prayer. Hallelujah. If you've got a prayer request, glory to God, I'm going to ask Brother Daniel to come up here and take up a prayer request this morning. If you got a prayer request, let it out, let it know. Glory to God, and we're just going to get into the service.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Anybody got a prayer request this morning?
Just remember the direction of the church. Remember me. Remember my lost loved ones. I have two more treatments. I'm believing God for a good report because He's what takes care of me.
Amen.
And He's what does.
Amen.
Y'all just remember me in prayer because, like I said, He's my Savior. He's my healer.
Amen.
He's my master. And He's my Jehovah Jireh. He is my provider.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And I'm looking for a good report in Jesus' name.
Amen. Remember Rita Walden this morning? Glory to God, she got to come home and Friday night and Saturday was Joe's birthday, so she got to come home and be with him for his birthday. But glory to God, she's got to go back the first, back to Lexington. They're going to start trying, if that infection's all gone, they're going to start giving her that radiation to try to shrink the cancer that's on her liver. We know a healing Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
That's right. We know a God that can take care of things that we can't take care of.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's pray for her today. Also remember our church.
Amen.
In general. I'm talking about the church in general. I'm talking about the church
Amen.
In general.
That's right.
I'm not talking about here. I'm talking about the church in general.
That's right.
Let's remember them that they'll get on fire for God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Remember our land and country this morning.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We need prayers for our land and country this morning. How many have been watching the news? May, in May, Jerusalem will become the capital of Israel. Early. The Bible said, when you see these things begin to take place, to look up, your redemption draweth nigh. He's even at the door. He's standing waiting. So let's remember our country. Remember the peace and pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Glory to God. Pray for everybody that you know that's lost.
Amen.
That they'll get saved. How many ask somebody to come to the house of the Lord today? Hallelujah. I ask y'all to ask somebody to come to the house of the Lord today. Glory to God, the only way that we're going to get them in the house of the Lord is we got to say, hey, won't you come and be with us this morning? Won't you come and be with us Thursday night? Won't you come and be with us Sunday night? And glory to God, we're going to see something happen. Hallelujah. I was praying out here last night and God showed me something. Hallelujah, Brother Daniel. And I believe if we get ready, church, we're going to see some things. Let's pray for me and my wife that we'll do what God would have us to do, that we'll try our best to lead y'all in the right way.
Amen.
That we won't lead you astray, but we'll lead y'all in the right way. Hallelujah. Somebody else. Glory.
Amen.
Remember me and my family and my lost loved ones.
Yes, Lord.
Remember Tanya, she's having health troubles once again on her knee. Remember her, remember my family, my lost, all my sisters and cousins and whatnot. They all lost. I ain't got very many family members on both sides of my family.
Amen. Amen.
In church that don't even know the Lord.
Amen.
And they need a lot of prayers for them.
Anybody else?
Y'all remember me and continue to remember Craig and remember Craig's friend.
Also remember Adam's uncle. He called yesterday and they think he's got cirrhosis of the liver. They're not for sure. But according to the MRI and stuff, that's what it's more or less looking for. And pancreas. So let's really remember him. He's lost. As far as I know, he's lost. I don't know. According to Adam, I believe he was. So let's remember him in prayer. Because he needs a touch from God, but he needs to be saved most of all.
Right. Amen.
If he don't know the Lord Jesus Christ as his Savior, he needs to know him. Amen. Most of all. Because say life is just like a vapor. It's here for a while and then it vanishes away.
That's right.
So let's remember him this morning.
Anybody else?
Remember me and Joshua that will follow the will of the Lord. And remember mine and my sister's friend, Tab. We call her Tabby. She lost her grandmother yesterday. She was really close to her. And I know how it's hard when I lost mine. And remember my friend Stephanie. She's fixing to have TNJ.
Anybody else?
Remember us in prayer. Remember you when you have your surgery next week. And pray for me and Cassie that we'll say or do something that will help the youth want to draw closer to the Lord.
That's right. Amen.
Amen.
Anybody else?
There's a lady that I have that passed away. Y'all remember their family.
Amen. Anybody else?
I'm trying to remember my mom and dad tonight. They're going through some things that they need God to move in. Just remember my dad's health.
Amen.
Anybody else?
Also pray for the service today that everybody keep their mind on the Lord.
That's right. Amen.
Anybody got a question? Let's go with Lee Payton. Pray it's the
Lord. Lord God, as I come to you, I pray for us this day. Thank you, Lord God, for your spirit that I can feel in this place. Dear God, I ask God that you would anoint this place this morning, Lord God. I pray, God, that you would just have your way in this service, God. I pray, God, you're going to teach me well, God. Lord, Sister Misty, Lord God, Sister Connie, God, Sister Bobby, Brother Jeff's world. God, we ask right now, God, in the name of Jesus, God, remember Sister Lord's request, God. God, remember that, Lord God, I pray this is to be a lolly, Lord God, you continue to touch her body, God. Heavenly Father, God, I pray, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, pray with her, God, share with God, Lord, Christ's request, God, pray for me, Lord God. I pray, God, that you would just move, God, save the lost loved ones, God. Remove it, Lord, Sister Connie, Lord God, touch her legs, God, touch her knees, God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, we just ask you right now, God, we just praise you, Lord. God, we pray for our lady country today, God, we pray for our president and our vice president, God. Heavenly Father, God, we pray for our leaders in our country, Lord God, for the governors, our senators, our leaders, Lord God, our congressmen, our leaders, Lord God, our chief of house, Lord. We pray for them, God, we pray that they get saved, God. God, we pray for the peace of Jerusalem, Lord God, we pray for Israel, Lord. Heavenly Father God, I just thank you, Lord God. Oh God, for what I can feel in my soul this morning. I acknowledge the joy of speaking, oh God. I'm exploring more. Oh God, I just ask God that you would bless us. God, bless the people here this morning. I'm moving on their knees this morning. Heavenly Father God, I pray, God, you see the hands that went up this morning. I pray, God, that you would move them all. Oh God, I thank you this morning. I for the joy that I can see in the spirit, Lord. I thank you for your presence this morning, Lord. I thank you, Honorable Sunday. I thank you for the Holy Ghost this morning, God. That dwells within me, Lord God.
Bless you.
God, we give you that praise this morning. God, we just ask you to have your way this morning. Bless each and every one. God, I ask God that the Holy Ghost set upon God. Let it press upon us this morning. Let them get in. Let them move this morning, God. As the Spirit begins to move in this place, let them eat of it, Lord. Let them take it in this morning, God. We ask, God, in your Son's precious name. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah!
your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be but converted and conformed to the ways of God, which I know didn't quite get just right. But that kept coming to me, that to pursue our bodies a living sacrifice.
Yes,
we have to do what God has us to do. We have to say what God has us to say. We have to live the way God wants us to live. Because we will answer to God. We won't answer to people, we'll answer to God. And it just kept coming to me. Present your body a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Your reasonable service to God is to praise Him, to lift Him up, to lift Him up and live for Him. You know, we praise with our hands. We praise with our lips, but we also praise with our life. By following Jesus and doing what He says, that's a form of praise, because we praise with our life, because we love Him, and we want to do what He wants us to do, and we want to go where He wants us to go, and we want to be what He wants us to be. So when we follow Him, and we live for Him, that's a form of praise with our life. We're praising Him with our life. I love the Lord.
Yes, Jesus. Yes, Jesus. Stay right there. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah, the presence of the Lord is in this place.
Amen.
Hallelujah, the presence of God is in this place this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Surely the Lord is in this place.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Psalms 106 says, praise ye the Lord. All give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. For his mercy endureth forever. Who can utter the mighty act of the Lord? Who can show forth all his praises? Blessed are they that keep judgment, and he that doeth righteousness at all times. Glory to God. In Psalms 111 says, praise ye the Lord. I will praise the Lord with my whole heart. In assembly of the unright, of the unright and congregation, upright and in the congregation. Hallelujah. Psalms 113. Praise ye the Lord. Praise all ye servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. From this time forth and forevermore, from the rising of the sun unto the going down of the same, the Lord's name is to be praised. The Lord is high above all nations, and his glory is above the heavens. Glory to God. In Psalms 134. Or 135. Praise ye the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise him, O ye servant of the Lord. Ye that stand in the house of the Lord, in the courts of the house of the Lord, of our God. Praise the Lord, for the Lord is good. Sing praise unto his name, for it is pleasing, pleasant. For the Lord has chosen Jacob unto himself, and Israel for his peculiar treasure. For I know that the Lord is great, that the Lord is above all gods. Whatsoever the Lord pleased, that he did. He in heaven and in earth, and in the sea and all the deep places. Hallelujah. And in Psalms 148, praise ye the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the highest. Praise him. Praise ye him, all ye angels. All his angels. Praise ye him, all his host. Praise ye him, sun and moon. Praise him, all ye stars of light. Praise him, ye heavens of heavens, and ye waters that be above the heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord for his commandments, and they were created. He has also established them forever and ever. He has made a decree which shall not pass. Praise the Lord from the earth, ye dragons of all deep. Hallelujah. And then go back with me over here. Glory to God, the Psalms 100. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye land. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and beat and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting. His endurance and his truth endures all generations. Glory to God. And I wrote something here. Glory to God, the act of praise. The act of praise. The act of giving thanks, grateful, acknowledgement of benefits, of favor, expectantly to God, expediently to God. An expression of thanks, expediently to God, especially to God. I was out here praying. Glory to God. You say, Brother Miller, you ain't going to pray. God's not being here.
Amen.
But I was out here praying last night. And I was talking to the Lord, Brother Wayne. And I've not been reading the Bible. Glory to God, I've done read it through. Hallelujah. I finished up Genesis the other night and I read the whole Bible through again. Glory to God. But did that stop me from reading it? No, I read it again. Hallelujah. But I was out here praying last night, Brother Wayne. Glory to God, and I found out something. Hallelujah. When we come into this place,
come on.
We don't come in here as the priest used to. Because the priest used to come in here by himself. And he would come into the holies of holies. And they would tie a scarlet robe upon his legs.
Right.
A purple. And it had a bells tied upon it.
Right.
And when he came into the court, he came in. And if they didn't hear that bells ringing, their blessing wasn't going to come. You see where I'm going with this?
Yeah.
So the priest came in, bearing the sins of the people. They brought lambs and bullocks to be sacrificed. And that priest had to sacrifice those lambs and things for their sins. But if that priest came into the holies of holies, and he came in unworthy, and he came in unclean, guess what happened? He dropped dead. And the bells did not ring. And guess what happened to those people that was outside? Their sins was not forgiven. And I thought, God, when we come into this place, now we don't have to have the priest. We don't have to go and say Hail Mary no more. We don't have to tell the priest our sins. We don't have to tell the pastors our sins. We just have to tell Jesus about our sins. And I thought, as I entered into this place, this is a sanctuary. This is a place that we come to worship God.
Amen.
I came in here last night. Brother Wayne, thank you, Lord.
Help me, Jesus.
I came in here last night. And I anointed every one of these chairs in this house. Amen. Every one of them. And I said, Lord, I want you to let the Holy Ghost saturate them.
Amen.
And I began to pray. And I began to talk to God. And I said, Lord, I want to be one of them. God, that you can use.
That's right.
I want to be one of them. Brother Wayne, it's in the last day. Revival. I want to be one of them that you can depend upon.
Amen.
And I heard a voice. Are you willing to sacrifice?
Lord.
Are you willing to come in my house with praise?
That's right.
Are you willing to there singing a song.
That's right.
That's not praise.
Right.
When we come into the holies of holies, that priest, when he came in that time with their sins, Brother Wayne, he was heavy. And he was burdened down with all their sins. He didn't know what all they had done.
Yep, and Lord.
But he came into that place with their sins.
Yep, and Lord.
And when he came in, he came in.
Yep,
and
Lord.
And he had to enter into the court.
Yep, and Lord.
With praise. He had to enter into the gates.
Yep, and Lord.
Right.
With thanksgiving. What's thanksgiving? Thanksgiving is given to God.
Amen.
Thanksgiving is giving your praise to God.
That's right.
Thanksgiving is not giving your money to God.
Right.
Thanksgiving is giving your time, your praise to God.
Right.
Then God will say, give your money to God.
Amen.
Glory to God. But you come in, you give God your thanks.
Give Him your
praise.
Right.
And did you know what the praise was?
Hallelujah.
That's what that priest would come in. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You say, Brother Miller, what are you talking about? When you mention that word hallelujah, all heaven stands at attention.
Yes.
You thought you was coming in here this morning going to hear a hell, fire, and brimstone message. But God said, you tell them that when they come into my courts, when they come into my place, when they come into my sanctuary, don't come in sit and look like you're dead. Don't come in sit and look like you're going to be clean. If you come into my place with worship, you come into my place with praise. You come in my place with your sins out the door. You don't bring your sins in the house of God.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's a lot of churches comes in. They got the form of godliness.
Right.
They deny the power. But they all want this.
Yep, Lord.
They're wanting this.
Right.
But God spoke to me and said, I will supply your needs.
Amen.
I will take care of it. You just leave it in my hands. Let me do it. Don't rob the people, but you let me give it to you. Behind the pulpit every morning, and they're robbing their congregation. Glory to God, they're telling them they're going to die and go to hell. You cannot do that. You've got to teach them the Word of God.
Amen.
You've got to teach them the Word of God. You've got to teach them, yes, I believe in paying your tithes. Yes, I believe in giving to God. But you don't have to hand it all the time.
Amen.
You don't have to hand it all the time. Glory to God. Jesus said, give what Caesar's, Caesar's. And what's God's, you give it to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And God said, I'll take that and I'll multiply.
Amen.
All people say you're supposed to prosper. Yeah, you're supposed to prosper in the Spirit of God. You're supposed to prosper. But the Bible said the love of money is the root of all evil.
That's right.
Amen.
That's one sin that entered into the house of God.
Right.
That's one sin that's bought many preachers airplanes.
Amen.
Bought many preachers Escalades.
Yep.
Cadillacs. Big mansions sitting out upon hills.
Right.
Glory to God, where they take and they'll talk about people that draws disability, but they'll take their money as soon as they send everything they got unto them. Glory to God. God said, you enter into my house. You're entering into my house with praise. And with thanksgiving. What did I just read? Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord.
Praise
ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. David said, when I came into the house, I came in with praise. I came in saying, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Come in a little more side. Glory to God. Hallelujah. People says, oh, Brother Miller.
Happen, Lord.
I just don't feel like praising God.
I just don't feel like giving God no praise. Hallelujah. When you come into this house, don't bring the things of this world into this house.
That's right.
Glory to God. The Bible says we're supposed to leave those things outside.
Amen.
Glory to God. And when I come in, I know, see, I'm going to come in praising my God. I'm going to give Him honor. Glory to God. Because sin lies at the door. You sin outside of the door. Don't take sin into the house of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You say, brother, the Bible says. Can I just go ahead and tell you? Malachi says to bring your tithes and give it to the storehouse.
Right.
Bring it in. He said, how have we robbed God through tithes and offering?
Help him, Lord.
God don't like a robber, right?
Amen.
God don't like a liar, neither.
Help him, Lord.
God don't like a thief, neither.
Right.
God don't like somebody that hates somebody.
Help
God
Lord.
Don't like somebody, glory to God, that takes and not gives.
Amen.
Help him, Lord.
That's right.
I'm just saying what the Word of God says.
Yeah.
Brother Wayne, God said when we come into this place,
yeah,
we're coming in here to worship Him.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah, Lord.
One preacher.
Yeah,
well, I ain't going to call him preacher, but one has stepped down. He's not going to preach no more.
Yeah, Lord.
He's not going to talk no more. Because
yeah,
his wife makes millions of dollars selling makeup. Well, guess what? Prayer changes things. Because if you ain't called to God, you don't need to be standing behind this right here trying to tell somebody that God loves you, that God cares for you, that God, all you have to do is just thank God, live a happy life, and plan to be okay.
Help
him, Lord. Oh, everything's hunky dory. No.
Help him, Jesus.
Uh-uh. Sin.
Help him, Lord.
Sin separates you from the love of God.
Help him, Lord.
Sin will cause you to die.
Help him, Lord.
You say, Brother Miller, you done lost your ever living mind.
Help him, Lord.
No, I'm just telling you what the Word of God says.
Help him, Lord.
If God starts dealing with your heart to start giving more money to the church, then you do it. Don't do it because somebody says do it, because I ain't telling you to.
Right.
I'm just telling you, you pray and talk to God. If God says, I want you to give more, then you give more. If God tells you to do something for the church, then you do it.
Amen. Right. Amen.
Come on. See, in the Bible days, Brother Wayne, they brought their cattle. Sister Misty, they brought their produce to the house of God. They brought it to the storehouse. And they put it at the storehouse. When they had 10 years of corn, that 10th ear of corn went to the Lord. Every 10 years of corn, that 10th one went to the Lord. So if you pick 20 years of corn, guess what? God got two of them. If you pick 10 tomatoes, God got one of them. He didn't want all of it.
That's right.
He wasn't a hog.
Help him, Jesus.
If you had 10 sheep, he got that 10th one. It didn't matter if it was the 10th one, he got it.
Help him, Lord.
You go out and buy 10 horses, guess what? God got that 10th one.
That's right.
It might have been the best horse that you had, but God was supposed to get it.
That's right.
Help him, man.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Amen.
God says in His Word that when we enter into His courts, we enter in with what?
Praise.
We enter into His gates with what?
Thanksgiving.
And into His courts with praise. You say, Brother Miller, you preaching on money? No, I'm not. No, I'm not. I'm going to stop that right now, devil. I'm not. I'm preaching on praise. I want you, when you come into this place, I want you to begin to praise God.
Amen.
I don't want you coming in here talking. I'd like for you to be here 30 minutes service so you can walk around and praise God. And say, God, you bless this church tonight. God, you bless the service tonight.
Yep,
Jesus. Hallelujah. You say, Brother Miller, what would that happen? Let me tell you what will happen.
Help him, Lord.
We'll have all kinds of services.
Right.
We'll see people healed. We'll send people set free and delivered.
Right.
We won't have to worry about these surgeries no more.
Yep.
We won't have to worry about back surgeries no more. Glory to God, because in this day that we're in right now, miracles is fixing to be performed, and God's going to give the praise. He said, come into my court with praise. Come in thanking me. Don't come in singing,
my wife, she went to tell me that I was doing things wrong. Yeah. Or there's a tear in my beer. And I'm crying for you, dear. You listen to that garbage, guess what? You can't praise God.
That's right. Right.
Right.
Right.
Right.
You listen to that bebop, hip-hop, and blip-blop and all that stuff, guess what?
Amen.
You can't come into the holies of holies and praise God.
That's right.
Lord.
Did you know there's churches out there right now? Man, they can go on Sunday morning, they can get up and they can sing Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound. They can sing, there's fire, 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 shut up in my bones. Glory to God, they can come in and they can sing, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to God, Jesus lifted me. I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. And Monday morning comes around, glory to God, they're out cussing. Glory to God, they're out smoking. Glory to God, they're out drinking alcohol. But here it comes Sunday morning. They come into the holies of holies, bringing those sins back into the church. They standing behind the pulpit, they're singing in the choir, glory to God. And they're not knowing what they're doing, but they're bringing sin into the house of God.
Amen.
That's right.
Oh, the pastor says, I'll preach it to them. I'll tell them it's okay to live that way. I'll tell them it's okay. Glory to God, as long
as...
You know, preachers, thank you, Lord. Did you know preachers is holding you up right behind the pulpit with a gun? And you don't even know it. Now you say, well, what are you talking about now, Brother Miller? They'll stand up behind that pulpit. And they're robbing you right there behind that pulpit.
That's right.
They're not feeding you the Word of God. They're not telling you the Word of God. Hallelujah. I listened to one last night. Hallelujah. And that's what got me stirred. Hallelujah. He said, we can come into God's courts. We come in with a praise. That don't mean to worship. That don't mean to sing. Glory to God. But God said to sing aloud unto the Lord. He said, make a joyful noise unto me. Glory to God. But when we come into this house, we come in with a praise upon our lips. Glory to God. But we come in to worship the Lord. Glory to God. Worship means to praise Him. Worship means to sing. And when you come in, you got to go through the praise first. Glory to God, you got to get hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God, you got to get that hallelujah in there. Glory to God, and then you enter into the thanksgiving and the gates of thanksgiving. Glory to God, you come in with thanksgiving. Oh, yes, give God thanks. God, you thank Him for bringing you here today. You thank Him for waking you up today. You thank Him, but then you enter into that court of praise and you begin to say hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't care if you have to say it 20 or 30 times. Say hallelujah. Come to your Lord's eyes. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. And when you get through that, you're making your way to the praising altars. Glory to God. You're making your way to an altar where you can get a hold of the horns of the altar. Glory to God. Ain't got no chair. Heaven breaks you right above Him. A lot of people that don't love God.
That's right.
But God loves you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Brother Wayne, and they make their way. But if they got sin in their life, they can't get past the thanksgiving.
Amen. Help them, Lord.
Woo!
That's right.
Brother Miller, that's hard. You got sin in your life and you bring it in the door.
Help them, Lord.
Guess what? You can't get past the thanksgiving.
Right.
Help them, Lord.
And how do you think you're going to get into that praise? Mm-hmm. How do you think you're going to get into the court of praise?
Right.
Huh? Oh, Lord, have mercy. Hallelujah. Brother Wayne, David know that he had sinned.
Right.
David know that he had done wrong.
Yes, he did.
David know that he had lied.
Right.
David know that he had committed adultery.
Right.
David know that he had committed fornication. David know that he had committed murder. And David know that he couldn't go into that place of holy,
right,
of holies, without talking to God.
Right.
So David went out where he always goes with his sheep, Brother Wayne. And David began to pray to God. And he said, Father, I pray that you won't take thy Holy Spirit from me.
Yes, you did.
He said, Lord, I know I've done these things. I've done wrong. But God, you know, Lord, that I have done things I shouldn't have done. God, I've committed murder. Lord, I have committed adultery. Lord, I've lied. Lord, I even had him to come here to my place, and I told the men to put him out on the front line. But he said, Lord, I pray thee that thou will not take thy Holy Spirit from me.
Right.
And God forgave David.
Amen.
David became the king that God wanted him to be.
Amen.
And David said, praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Hallelujah. He said, let everything that has breath walk, praise ye the Lord. Glory to God. I'm telling you today, when you enter into that door, you better make sure that you're ready. You better make sure that you ain't got sin in your life. Glory to God. And a lost person is going to have sin in their life. But a Christian person, a child of God, they better make sure that they've got things under the blood. Because when you enter into this place, you're coming into a place of worship. You're coming into a place that's been sanctified. You're coming into a place that's holy. Glory to God. As I was praying last night, I began to thank God for a place that we could come and praise Him. I began to thank God for a place that He gave us. And that's when I heard that voice. You want to praise me, you begin to praise me. But you, when you come into this place, you come in with praise. You come in with a praise for you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I was thinking, I'll close my eyes when I say this. But I was thinking last night, Brother Wayne. I'll just look at the cross. But I was thinking last night. If Jesus said, I'm coming, and I'm going to be here at 7 o'clock, what time would you roll in to go with Him?
Come on.
5 minutes after, guess what? The bridegroom's done gone. Last minute, might be too late.
That's right.
You say, Brother Miller, what are you getting at? God said we better be in here and praise. We better be getting in His house and praise. Because, church, can I tell you something? We ain't seen nothing yet.
That's right.
We ain't seen nothing. The Christians ain't seen nothing. You think you've been persecuted? You ain't seen nothing.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You ain't seen nothing. And how you going to get ready for that? By coming into the house of God with praise. Hallelujah. The Bible says, in 2 Chronicles 16:7, it said, and the priest went into the inner part of the house of the Lord. I came in here last night. I'm not the priest, but I'm the pastor. And I came in here last night. I'm just going to paraphrase it right now. It says, and the pastor went into the inner part of the house of the Lord to clean it. I ain't talking about sweeping the floor. I ain't talking about cleaning the toilets. And brought out all the uncleanness that they found in the temple of the Lord, unto the court of the house of the Lord. And the Levites took it and carried it out abroad unto the brook of Cherith. Who is the lad? That's y'all. In other words, the pastor has come into this house last night. And I came in here to clean it out. I came in here to get it ready for you to come in here this morning to praise him. You say, Brother Miller, where'd you get that from? God gave it to me this morning. Other translation says, but I don't believe in these other translations. I believe in the King James Bible, but the other translations breaks it down. They say, we got to break it down so the kids can understand the Word of God. But Jesus said he made it so plain that a child could understand it.
Amen.
So there's something not right there with that picture. But they say that the priest came in and he went into the hidden part. He came into the house. Coming in and he just swept, you know. No, he came into the house to clean it out. Glory to God, just like I came in here this morning, I came in here to get the unbelief out. I came in here to get the unrighteous out of here.
Right.
I came in here to get the sin out of the house.
Amen.
I came in here, glory to God, to get the uncleanness. Somebody in here this morning, you need to hear this.
Amen.
Somebody in live stream, you need to hear this. When you go into your house of praise, you better not have no uncleanness in you.
Right.
You better not have nothing that ain't like God in you.
Yeah,
because
yeah.
God will call it out, glory to God. God will let you know you can't play church. Glory to God. Yeah. Oh, that's this one last night. Oh, he got up there. I ain't going to say his name because y'all know him as soon as I got talking. Anyway, they were all sitting up there in their little blue suits. You know, the women sit up there in their little blue suits. Little choir things, I guess you want to call it. And he got up there and he had an apple out there. He had a peach out there. He had a kiwi out there. He had some corn seeds. He had some watermelon seeds. Glory to God, he had some tomato seeds. Hallelujah. And he said, glory to God, God won't bless you unless you bless him. God won't bless you, glory to God, unless you give a seed. God won't bless you. God won't touch you. God ain't going to let you feel his spirit unless you give a seed. Glory to God. And he cut that kiwi open. And he said, I like this one because it's got a lot of seeds in it. In other words, he said, I'm liking this one because it's going to fill my pockets. Glory to God. The Bible said, freely give, freely shall you receive. Glory to God. And I thought about that, Brother Wayne. Glory to God. The Bible said that they were some Pharisees and scribes. Glory to God. They were boasting about what they were giving and bragging about what they were putting in the offerings. And this little old woman, wretch in her pocket. Brother Wayne, she wretch in her pocket. And she pulled out two little mites. In our days, it's pennies. And she walked up there. And she put two mites in it. And guess what? Jesus blessed her more because she gave from the heart.
Amen.
She sowed the seed of Jesus. Jesus is the seed. If you read the Bible, Jesus is the seed. Money's not the seed. Money's not the seed. Oh, yeah. He said, you take this right here. This is the seed. If I put that in the ground, am I going to have a money tree growing?
No.
Roger, if I put that in the ground, it's just going to stay there, ain't it?
Right.
Y'all get what I'm saying?
So money, it's going to rot.
Oh, it's paper. What's paper made out of? It was made out of a seed. It was made out of wood. But guess what? Wood rots away. And it goes to dust. It goes back down to dirt. Oh, but that's the seed that you sow right there. You sow this.
Jesus said you sow this right here.
Right.
The word.
Amen.
From the beginning, God sowed the word. From the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And the things under the earth, the things beneath the earth, the things above the earth. God created them.
Amen.
The seed was the word. And who was the word? The word died on the cross. Did he die on the seed? No, he died on the cross. He died on the old tree that they had cut and made a cross.
But he rose again.
You say, Brother Miller, what are you getting at? You send me $1,000 and I give you a word from God. All that preacher wants is that $1,000. Brother Roger, that's all he wants. Because God said he would give it to you freely. Because he paid the ransom right there on that cross for you. But he told me to tell you today. Today. Make a joyful noise
unto the Lord, all ye
lands. Unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, not gloom and doom. Serving God ain't gloom and doom. He said, serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with what? No. He said, come before the Lord, come before his presence with singing. Singing.
There's more scriptures in there besides.
Knowing ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and his sheep of his pasture. Enter unto his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good and his mercy is everlasting and his truth endureth all generations. There's other places in the Bible that says enter into his courts. There's other places in the Bible says to give thanks. But he said to enter into his courts. Oh, y'all, I got one more scripture to read to y'all, and it's in Revelation. Hallelujah. Revelation 19. It says, and after these things, I heard a great voice of much people in heaven saying,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Not hallelujah. Hallelujah. Which means hallelujah. Salvation and glory and honor and power unto the Lord our God. For true and righteousness are in judgment.
Are his judgment.
For he has judged the great whore which did corrupt the earth with her fornication, and has avenged the blood of his servant at her hand. And again they say, hallelujah. And her smoke rose up forever and ever. And the 24 elders and the four beasts fell down and worshiped God that sat on the throne, saying, amen, hallelujah. And a voice came out of the throne saying, praise God, all ye his servants, and ye that fear him, both small and great. Hallelujah means hallelujah. So that's the last chapter of the Bible. And he still says to praise him, Brother Wayne. When you come into his courts,
come into his house with praise.
That scripture that I was telling you a while ago, before the devil tries to sit on my head and tell me, you don't know this and you didn't do that. The Bible said, the scripture that kept coming to me is Romans 12:1. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And this is the one I got mixed up on. Verse 2, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
Right.
So, you say, Brother Biller, when we come into the house now, what are we supposed to do?
Praise the Lord.
Come in praising Him. You say, Brother Miller, I just don't feel like it sometimes. I just don't feel like coming in praising Him.
You don't feel like waking you up.
Yeah, thank you, Sister Nora. Well, what if He don't feel like blessing you through the week? What if He says, well, you're going to be sick and you ain't going to go to work? Guess what? You don't go to work, you don't get paid.
Right?
You know, people go to work, they give all that they've got to please their informant or their boss. They want to let them know that they are a good worker. Well, God wants you to know when you come into His house, He wants you to please Him. He wants you to give Him praise, give Him glory, and give Him honor. If we give Him honor where honor's due, guess what? God's going to bless you. You see this right here? God said to make a box. And all you have to do, I don't have to know who you are. You just drop it in this box. Because the Bible said it's supposed to be done in secret. I don't go around and write people's names down and keep a record. That's not my job. My job is to preach the Word of God to you. And my job is to tell you that you got to do what God says to do. But you give what God wants you to give. And God wants you to give Him your time. God wants you to give Him 10% of the day to Him. He's giving you 24 hours. All He wants you to do is just give Him 10% of it.
Here today, and you're lost.
he's going to the church to sing in the choir and to give God praise. He go back down and do the same thing over and over. Do the same old alcohol. Do the same old drugs. Do the same old prostitute. And suddenly moves around and you go right back into the house of God to try to give him praise. By the way, thank you. from you. But how you gonna get what you need? You gotta ask.
Christ.
You gotta see.
Amen.
God's not gonna come down.
Somebody today.
Jesus is calling somebody today. glad to be in the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Boy, that was weak.
How many's glad to be in the house of the Lord?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I'm so glad that Jesus lifted me.
Amen.
I'm so glad, Brother Wayne, that I can come into this place. Hallelujah, I can come out here and unlock the door, Brother Austin, and I can come in here and get along with my God. I can get along with my Savior, and I can begin to talk, Brother Roger, to Him. Hallelujah, I can come out here, Lord and God, and me and God just have us a good old time. Hallelujah, because I want to come into His place with a worship. I want to come into His place with a praise. I want to come into His house with thanksgiving, Lord and God, to give Him honor and to give Him thanks. Hallelujah, for what He's done in my life. Hallelujah. I pray for every one of y'all. I prayed for the whole church last night. I prayed for the whole church. Hallelujah. Glory to God, we got the playlist over here. If you want to be in the play, please sign your name on the play thing over here. Glory to God, because we're fixing to start this.
Practice starts Tuesday night.
Next Tuesday night.
This Tuesday night.
This Tuesday.
Tuesday, because you only got like
39. Yeah. Well, Wednesday at 6.
Yes.
Wednesday at 6, bring your kids here. Because we're going to teach them some songs. So, because Thursday night is youth service. And we want all the youth to be here.
Play practice times are going to be Tuesday at 6, Friday at 6, and maybe occasionally every other Sunday, depending on how you do during practice.
But Thursday night is youth service. And I want God just to come into this place. I want the young people. Now listen to me, young people. I want you to enter into this court. I want you to come in with thanksgiving. I want you to come in and give God thanks. Then I want you to come in and give God praise. I don't want you coming in here just sitting and talking. I want you to come in here saying hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You say, Brother Miller, what's that mean? That means when you start saying hallelujah, guess what? God's fixing to bless you. God's fixing to pour something upon you that you ain't never had before. Glory to God, He's fixing to anoint you like you've never been anointed before. Glory to God, when you start coming in and giving Him thanks and you start coming in and giving Him praise, I'm telling you, church, you start doing it, I guarantee you, you're going to get blessed.
Amen.
But Thursday night, please bring the young people to church Thursday night. For the youth service. Glory to God. Because I believe something good is going to happen. I believe something good is on its way. Now this is just a little taste of what's fixing to happen.
Amen.
This is just a little taste of what's fixing to take place. Glory to God. Appreciate you. How would anybody want to testify? Anybody? Amen. Hallelujah. Thank God. Somebody else.
I want to thank the Lord for this church. It's been a big blessing on me and my family. I heard you preach at other church that you go to. I always said I'd never have a church that I'd love to go be a member. I never thought I'd go to that. You know, it happened. Well, it's here. So God is working blessings all the time. You never know what's going to be in store.
That's right.
So, I just thank
you
for the church,
though.
Amen. You did a wonderful job.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Somebody else?
I just want to thank the Lord for being here and for saving my soul and for what I felt this morning and for the service and everybody that comes out here and for my family and everything.
Amen. I was trying to get Josh to get you on the camera. You shouting back there. I said, get Bonnie. Get Bonnie. Hallelujah. That's old Bonnie there. Hallelujah. Somebody else.
I thank you, praise the Lord, for being here. And thank you for everything He means to me. For everything He's always done for me. He's always healed my body. And I thank Him and I praise Him that he lets me wake up every day and lets me breathe. And I even told Miller this morning, he said, I thank you for my life. I said, I thank you, Lord, for waking my little dog up.
Amen. Somebody else. Amen. Somebody else.
You know God was in it, because you definitely would have broke them ankles in them shoes.
Somebody else.
I thank the Lord for the blessing that I got this morning. I thank you for everything you've done for me. Thank the Lord for the church. And I just want to always be in His will, do His will. And y'all just pray for me that I'll always stand for the Lord, always say, do, speak, and be what He wants me to be.
Amen. Somebody else.
I thank the Lord for being here. I thank Him for saving me, sanctifying me, filling me with the Holy Ghost. I had intentions on singing a song that I've been practicing the past few days, but while I kept sitting here, the Lord was dealing with me about singing Listen to Me, Devil. So I thank the Lord that He moved this morning. I'm thankful for His presence and everything He's done for us.
Amen. Somebody else. Somebody else.
Also want to thank the Lord for my husband.
Amen.
Friday was 10 years that we've been married, and I thank God for him.
Amen. Look at them ears get red back there. Bless his heart. Somebody else.
Yep, right in the prayer box.
Yeah, we'll do that.
I also want to thank the Lord, you know. I put on the internet, because I was talking to Joshua, I was like, and we was on his day last night, I said, you know, for us to have a little church, we have quite a bit of kids in our youth service, in our youth. I said, hey, so how many of you guys? So we got about 14 or 15, but I got actually added up, and we got about 20. And I thank God for that, and I'm hoping and praying that God will lead me and Missy to teach them the right way, and we follow God's will.
Amen. Somebody else. How many wants to hear the assistant pastor preach tonight? He done good. Thursday night. Or Sunday night. Last Sunday night, he done good. Sister Nora just opened the gun up on us and shot us all on Thursday night.
She did.
Yeah, she didn't. She made sure that gun was going. She made sure them shots went from one side. But anybody else want to testify?
I just want to thank the Lord for being here this morning and thank the Lord for saving my soul. We all should be thankful for something. And, you know, if you're saved, you should be thankful for the Lord saving your soul.
Amen.
And I praise God for this little kid right here. Don't know his name, but...
Bryson.
And I praise God for everybody here that's here this morning. And come back expecting a good service tonight.
Amen.
Amen.
My family for the past 10 and 11 years.
She left out yesterday with our 11-year anniversary of being together. So I've had to put up with her 11 years. So.
Yeah.
Bless. Amen. Somebody else. We seen Sister Terry the other day. She couldn't wait to be here this morning.
Yep.
Hallelujah.
Well, that yesterday was wrapped in Craig's leg. He really wrapped his leg like the doctor told us to. I had his leg lay over my lap. I sat there rubbing his leg from his foot up to just about his waist. And he looked at me and he said, "Hey, this is the first time I felt that. A long time. God's moving on it, man."
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Everybody's here this morning. Glad you're here. Come back tonight. Expect God to do something. If you want God to do something, you got to come back. You got to come back expecting God to do it. Hallelujah. We got to sing the happy anniversary to Daniel and Misty.
Tomorrow's Emily's birthday.
Huh? I took her that last Sunday.
Tomorrow's Emily's birthday.
Yeah.
We're
going to
her last Sunday.
Yeah, we're going to do it again. We send that word right now, God, to these homes, God, into these houses, God, into these people. God, it's in this box. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I believe in people working in the house of God. Hallelujah. I believe in putting people to work. Hallelujah. That's what churches need. They need people working in them. Hallelujah. They need people that's willing to say, "Hey, Pastor, I'll help. Pastor, I'll help do something. If you need something, just ask me. I'll help." Glory to God. It don't matter if it ain't nothing but anything in a trash can back there. Do it. God bless you for it. Hallelujah. If it's just picking up a piece of paper off the floor when you get ready to leave, pick that piece of paper up. God bless you for it. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Man, it's been good being in the house of the Lord this morning.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm blessed. Now, who wants to be baptized? Come on up here and stand right underneath the spout.
Oh, so that's my word.
Come out here last night, and I thought, "Oh, Lord Jesus,
garbage cans.
They're supposed to come and paint the roof. They're going to seal the roof. Yeah, we got to get all that water from out of the ceiling first, because it's probably laying up there in that plastic. That insulation is laying there. So, he's coming to, I reckon tomorrow, it's supposed to be nice out tomorrow. They're going to paint this roof. They're going to seal it. Hallelujah. That's like some of us. We get a crack in our vessel and we got to have it sealed. The only thing can seal it is the Holy Ghost.
Right.
Amen. You know, some preachers don't preach it anymore, but I'm going to tell you this, and then we're fixing to go. But before you can get the Holy Ghost, you listen to me, before you can get the Holy Ghost, you got to be sanctified real good.
Right,
amen. Hallelujah, because that's what's going to keep you.
The
sanctification. What is sanctification? Setting yourself from apart from this world. Turn yourself around. And then when you get sanctified real good, guess what? The Holy Ghost will come in.
That's another
sermon. Well, that might be Brother Wayne's. I don't know. Hallelujah. But that's what's lacking in the house of God today is sanctification. And you know why? Because people don't want to live that life. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
They don't want to live that life that makes them holy. They don't want to live that life that can take them to heaven. They just want to live the easy way out. But it don't work that way. Hallelujah. I appreciate the Lord. Anybody want to say anything else before we dismiss? Okay, we're going to dismiss. I'm going to ask Brother Austin to dismiss us.
Come back tonight, Lord.
Yes.
Ask that you'll bless the service and ask in your name.
Amen. Amen.